You know how many religions are there in the world? 4,200 religions in the world. 4,200 different laws. 20 forms of governments ruling different countries. And on the other hand, you have only Islam, the last and the final constitution given by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is Al-Quran. But when you look around the world, these religions and these concepts, these governments, they are unable to solve the problems of the society. They are unable to solve the problems of the mankind because they are man-made laws. You see, man-made laws, if you apply, they are utterly failed. I would like to discuss some of the issues, some of the major and main issues, so that society can come at least closer to peace, inshallah. One of the main social issue is alcoholism that we see in the world. According to World Health Organization, there are about 3 million people who die because of intoxication. He loses the senses of differentiating between right and wrong. What does the law say? Is there any law in the world? When the society, the mankind, when they are not accepting the law of God, then there is peacelessness in the society. Surah Maida, Surah number 5, Ayat number 90, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhallazina amanu, O you people who have believed, innamal khamru wal maisiru wansabu wazlamu rijsum min amali shaitan. Intoxication, gambling, divination by stones, dedication by arrows, all these things are abomination of shaitan's handiwork. Shaitan instigates you to take this. When this ayah was revealed, the barrels in the Medina, they were flown on the roads, never to be refilled again. This is how we have to accept the law of the God. 3 million people die because of alcoholism. And Prophet said, alcoholism is the mother of all evils. And the most important issue for the mankind, terrorism. Many people use the term Islamic terrorism. What is Islamic terrorism? When you say Islamic, it means peace. Surah Maida, Surah number 5, Ayat number 32, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you, any one of you, kills anybody, whether he may be a Muslim or a non-Muslim, without any reason, it is as though he has killed the whole of the humanity, and the curse of whole of the humanity will be upon him. And if anyone saves the life of any innocent human being, it is as though he has saved the life of the entire mankind. The basic tagline of Islam and Muslims is that we Muslims promote peace, and we are the peaceful people because we follow the most peaceful human being on the face of the earth, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the most important issue for the mankind, the spiritual issue. You solve all the issues. Financial issue is solved. Educational issue is solved. A medical issue is solved. Social issue is solved. Everything is solved. But what about the spiritual issue? Now comes the main role of Muslims. There are about 4,200 religions in the world, as well as 20 different forms of governments ruling the world. And on the other hand, as I said, Islam, the complete way of life. So what is our job in getting humanity in spiritual issue from darkness to light? The role now applies dawah. What dawah? Dawah of inviting mankind to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So our job is in the spiritual issue, in the spiritual value, we have to go to them and explain, not force them. Not forcing. Islam does not believe in forced conversions or forced, you know, teachings. Explain them or give them the message that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you're talking about change, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the formula for the change. Allah says in Surah Ra'd, Surah number 13, Ayat number 11, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma bi qawmin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not change the conditions of the people. We are talking about all the conditions, all these issues are the conditions of the mankind, right? Allah says, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma bi qaumin. Allah does not change the conditions of the people. Hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Unless they change what is in themselves.